In the industrial age of our recent past, one of the most important measures of company success was productivity, how well people were able to produce outputs from a given set of inputs. I think increasingly, in the ever faster changing knowledge-based economy of the future, one of the most important measures of a company's success will not be just its productivity, but its intelligence. How intelligent can a company be in recognizing and responding more and more rapidly to the changes in the environment around it? More and more, I think, we need companies that are collectively intelligent. And I think our new technologies and new ways of work give us more and more opportunities for creating more and more intelligent organizations. So one of the techniques that's needed to create more intelligent organizations is learning how to specialize out certain tasks to be done by people who are highly skilled at those tasks, while letting other people weave together the work of many of those hyper-specialists into an overall intelligent response to whatever challenges are confronting an organization at a given time. But in more and more cases, by breaking work down into smaller and smaller pieces, we'll be able to get economic benefits of doing the same thing cheaper because people are more specialized. You get a kind of economies of scale for doing it. We'll get speed benefits because in many cases you'll be able to do many things in parallel. Many parts of the problem can be done in parallel instead of one after another by the same person. For instance, it's easy to imagine that you could transcribe a two-hour video or two-hour talk in 10 minutes if you break the 2 hours into small segments done in parallel. Another benefit is quality. By taking a piece of a task to one of the best people in the world for doing that task, you may be able to get it done not only faster, but also much better than if you take your person who lives nearby who happens to be able to do it, but not nearly as well as one of the world experts. So better, faster, cheaper are the primary benefits that come in the cases where this is desirable from dividing work in this way. I think the thing that's driving hyper-specialization now is the dramatic reductions in the costs of communication. New information technologies, email, the World Wide Web, the internet in general. These technologies are now reducing the costs of communication to such a low level that it's now possible for almost any kinds of information to be sent almost anywhere on the planet, almost instantly, and almost free. The winners from this trend toward hyper-specialization will, in the early days, be those who figure out what's happening sooner than others, and therefore figure out how to take advantage of it sooner than others. In the long run, I think the winners will be those who develop skills, perhaps often highly specialized skills, that are in demand by the global knowledge marketplace.